deep in the bowels of a hidden bunker, somewhere under the brick and steel of a nondescript building, we've once again made contact with our leader, Mark Levin.
Mr. Producer, would you open your mic, please?
Ladies and gentlemen, there is absolutely nothing wrong with the president and or his lawyers calling out this prosecutor. Nothing. There's nothing unethical about it. There's nothing immoral about it. There's nothing unlawful about it. I mean, they have to decide if it's useful or not. But in many ways, it is. Because if it comes down to impeachment over a fabricated allegation, the case has to be made in the court of public opinion. Why wouldn't the president fight back? Why wouldn't the president call Mueller exactly what he is? Why wouldn't the president notice he only hires Democrats? Why wouldn't the president call all these things out? What, Jeff Flake's going to do it? Marco Rubio's going to do it? Lindsey Graham's going to do it? Who the hell in the Senate's going to do it? Name one. Where's McConnell? Where's John Cornyn? Where's Lamar Alexander? Where are any of them? Nowhere. So if Trump doesn't defend himself against Mueller, nobody is. In fact, these damn fools are, you know, we're going to pass a law to protect Mueller. They can't pass a law to protect Mueller, you clowns. He's a subordinate of the President of the United States. It's so, you know, frustrating when you understand history and the Constitution. It really is to watch this. It's frustrating as hell. And then there's Trey Gowdy. You know, Mr. Producer, we have to have a new rule. Never trust a guy who doesn't comb his hair the same way each day for the next 5 days in a row. Mr. Gowdy is now getting more and more popular. Being from South Carolina, he's got part of the Lindsey Graham disease. He's going after Ben Cardin. He's going after some jerk in the White House who had to resign. Yeah, yeah. It's very, very. And he was in head of the Benghazi special committee, and that went far. He was involved in oversight involving Samantha Power. That went nowhere. The guy's all talk. All talk. But I want you to listen to what he had to say on Fox News Sunday. Cut five, go.
I want to begin by getting your reaction to President Trump's lawyer calling for Rod Rosenstein, the deputy attorney general, to end.
Hey, let's it's Rosenstein. Rosenstein, that's his name. Let's start at the beginning. Go ahead.
I want to begin by getting your reaction to President Trump's lawyer calling for Rod Rosenstein, the deputy attorney general, to end the Mueller investigation. Do you support that?
Now, hold on a second. What is wrong with that? Well, the lawyer saying the prosecutor needs to end his investigation of my client. Is that really a shocking statement? Oh, my God, that's over the top. What did he say? He wants the prosecutor to stop investigating him. Isn't that exactly what Menendez said? How about poor Ted Stevens, who was prosecuted by the Department of Justice? In fact, by the oddly named Public Integrity Section of the Criminal Division in Washington, D.C. And they obstructed justice, and they withheld evidence. They did all sorts of stuff. The judge was so furious, I believe it was Judge Sullivan, that he referred these prosecutors to OPR and to their bar for disbarment consideration. No, you can't question the prosecutors. Never question the prosecutors. Unless it's Ken Starr, then you can trash the guy left and right. Trash him left and right. And now we Republicans, let's pass a statute to protect Mueller. Your statute would be unconstitutional, you morons. Anyone in the media know that? Chuck? No? George? No? Jake? No? Now you don't know that? Well, let's hear what the great Trey Gowdy had to say. Go ahead.
I don't, and I think the president's attorney, frankly, does him a disservice. when he says that and when he frames.
So the president's attorney does the president a disservice when he says the prosecutor should end his investigation. Are you really as stupid as you sound, Trey? May I call you Trey? I've never met you, but Trey, have you ever been an advocate for a client?
I really think they do a disservice when they tell the prosecutor to get his investigation over with.
Why is that, Trey? Why is that a disservice? Go ahead.
That way, Chris, if you look at the jurisdiction for Robert Mueller, first and foremost, what did Russia do to this country in 2016? That is supremely important, and it has nothing to do with collusion.
Wait. Has nothing to do with collusion. Now we have Trey Gowdy as a special pleader from Mueller. See, folks, this has nothing to do with collusion. It has to do with what did the Russians do to interfere with our election. So, Mr. Gowdy, was it Mr. Mueller who determined that Hillary Clinton campaign and the DNC funded the Fusion GPS dossier? No, it wasn't. Is it Mr. Mueller who's called Hillary Clinton as a witness, Mr. Gowdy? No, it's not. Is Mr. Mueller who's called top officials at the DNC as witnesses? Did he call them in front of his grand jury? No, he didn't. Well, tell me, Mr. Gowdy, did he call Susan Rice in front of his grand jury? Where now we have a book where she said specifically, stand down to the cybersecurity experts who wanted to do something? No, we don't. So, Mr. Gowdy, you don't have the foggiest idea what the hell you're talking about. If Mr. Mueller is investigating Russian interference, why is he investigating one campaign? And why is he now investigating obstruction? Which is an impossibility in this instance. Oh, Trey, you must have missed that Constitution 101 class in the first year of law school. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
To suggest that Mueller should shut down and that all he is looking at is collusion, if you have an innocent client, Mr. Dowd, act like it.
Oh. So if you have an innocent client, Mr. Dowd, act like it, according to the former federal prosecutor. So you shouldn't tell the prosecutor to cut it out, Mr. Dowd, because your client's innocent. What else? What other advice would Mr. Gowdy give? Should he go in there and do a full-blown interview, Mr. Gowdy? Should he do that, too? When you have a prosecutor who's looking to trip up the president? That wouldn't be wise.
Well, we have an innocent client. Why not? Why not? You have an innocent client. Go ahead and send him in there. What's wrong with that? And he's not limited to collusion. He's investigating Russian interference. Well, I didn't know that. When did that happen? Well, did you look at what Rosenstein said? Russian interference.
You don't hire a prosecutor to investigate Russian interference. That's a counterintelligence investigation, not a criminal investigation, you idiot. I'm sick of these stupid lawyers who get elected to Congress and then go on TV. That's a counterintelligence investigation, not a criminal investigation. You don't appoint a special prosecutor to look into a counterintelligence matter like this.
Do you, Trey? No, you don't. And how dare the president's lawyer suggest that the prosecutor should stop? If you have an innocent client, you know, you don't say stuff like that.
Get out of here.
Mark Levin.
Question. If Trump were to fire Mueller, I'm not advocating it at all. I'm asking, how does that create a constitutional crisis? What's the constitutional crisis? Congress has the power to impeach. The House does. The Senate has the power to remove. What is the constitutional crisis exactly? I'm confused. Or if Mueller were to be replaced with another prosecutor, what's the problem? The problem is, folks, the Democrats and the media love Mueller. Because Mueller is out to destroy Trump. That's why. It's that simple. It's not a constitutional crisis. What's the constitutional crisis? The president has the power to fire him. The Democrats don't want him to fire him. The repubes don't want him to fire him. That doesn't make it a constitutional crisis. They're just setting up more and more this foundation for impeachment, impeachment, impeachment. That's what's going on. The Democrats would be elated if Trump fired Mueller. They keep warning him, don't fire Mueller. And then behind the scenes, yeah, do it, please, please, please. They'd be absolutely elated. So would Jeff Flake, the Flakester. But now, you see, we have to protect Mueller. Mueller is the victim, you see, the potential victim of Donald Trump. Well, we know all about Donald Trump's wife. We know all about Donald Trump's children. What do we know about Mueller's wife and his children? Nothing. Somebody threatening Mueller? What do we know about Mueller's business activities? Anything? Nothing. What about his kids and his wife? Nothing. So what's the problem? It all goes one way. Anybody can say anything about the President of the United States or any member of his family, most of which are lies, but some of it might be true. But you can't criticize Mueller. Let's see. Mueller went into Manafort's apartment with the FBI, guns drawn. Am I allowed to criticize that? Mueller's in two jurisdictions. He's thrown enough charges against Manafort where he'd have to spend 5 lifetimes in prison. Am I allowed to criticize that? Mueller went back after Flynn, after his buddy Comey decided that Flynn didn't intentionally lie. He was set up by Stroke, set up by Mueller. Am I allowed to criticize that? Am I allowed to criticize the fact that Mueller hired all Democrats virtually? Am I allowed to criticize the fact that his number two guy, his right-hand lieutenant, is a piece of you-know-what? Am I allowed to say that? No, 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 no. Protect Mueller at all costs. Right, Trey?